What's up guys, in this video I'm going to help improve your fashion week photography so that next time you shoot a fashion show, you'll do it like a pro. Fashion week's around the corner and lots of you will be going to fashion week for the first time, you'll be going to shows and there's a lot of mistakes that I see people making because everyone wants to put their pictures up on Instagram, especially on Instagram stories now. Always want that first look. I'm not gonna lie, a lot of them suck. But we're gonna fix that today. So I've got a few tips because I've been doing Fashion Week for a long time. I'm not talking about doing the end of the runway. I've been there, I've done that. It's horrible, don't do it, it's dull. I'm gonna give you tips to help improve your fashion show photography when you're at the side of the runway. The first tip, realistically, is that you're not style.com or Vogue Runway or Vogue or whatever the hell this website's called anymore, but you know, you're not there to do that classic end of the runway shot where it's just the model on the runway and it's kind of straight up and down, very matter of fact, dull. You have the ability to be more creative. You can look at your composition. You can actually capture the atmosphere, especially if you're YouTubing and you want to create kind of like a visual diary of your time at Fashion Week. Yeah, especially if you're at the back. I mean, because, you know, for all the will in the world, we all want to be a front row, and sitting front row is great. You get the best view. But if you are at the back, include the people, include the show. Also think about, you know, the placement of the model in the picture. You know, they don't have to be slap bang in the middle. They can be off to one side. You know, there's things like the rule of thirds, which, you know, I'll put a link to the rule of thirds in the description below. You don't just have to do the full outfit. You know, maybe you want to just do details. Maybe you just want to do hair. I don't know, maybe that particular day you're just going to do belts. Whatever it is, but be creative. Don't just do the same thing for every show, because especially if you're going to start blogging it or Instagramming it, it's going to get very dull and repetitive if it's the same thing over and over and over again. Obviously, there's a massive difference between being at the back, and obviously you're not going to get full looks. You'll get heads and that kind of thing in the way, which, you know, if that's where you are, that's where you are. Don't necessarily hide it. I don't believe in like, oh, look at me front row, if you're not front row. You know, everyone starts somewhere. At some point you'll get moved up, that's the way things work. Little tip though, if you're seated or you're standing at the back and you get there early, try and get one of the end positions on the end of the row, especially if it's a bench rather than individual seat. Often that will get you a gap to shoot down, so you're more likely to start getting full outfit shots. You know, think about that. Also, if you want good pictures, scout out. Sometimes you get pillars and stuff like that, which could obscure your view. If you've already been to one of the shows earlier in that same venue, often the models will walk in the same direction. So if you've already been to that same venue for another show, make a mental note of where the models come out, which direction they go, because that will actually help you to, you know, work out where you're sitting. Obviously, this only applies if there is a bench. If it is individual seating, that's much more difficult. Equally, as far as the lighting goes, normally it's set up for one specific direction. So normally, and it's 9 times out of 10, it's the direction facing the photographer's pit. So bear that in mind, that, you know, where you're sitting. I know I went to a show once and it was a horseshoe shape, and I didn't have a choice of where I sat. It was just where I happened to be put. Realistically, I only ever really saw the back of the models. That's just the way things go sometimes. So understand that you can't get all of them, and some you win, some you lose. So just be aware, like, kind of scout out the surroundings and that kind of thing. I mean, one thing that I really like to do when I've got the opportunity, I actually sit at the opposite end of the photographers, just because I prefer, when I'm doing shots, because I'm trying to create more of an atmospheric documentary, the kind of stuff that you'd see in a book basically, or on a wall somewhere. I often like to have the model facing the photographers with all the lights behind. That to me is a far more interesting shot than just the standard here's an outfit. I still do those as well, especially if it's a particular outfit I like, because that's just, you know, that's what you're there for, to do. A little tip, if you are sitting front row, one thing I like to do, most cameras now have an articulating screen, and what I find really interesting is you can pre-compose your shot. So like I said, I like to have the model up near the photographers with all the lights and everything. I will have my shot pre-composed, and I'll have it sitting on, have the camera sitting on my lap, so that as the model walks past, I can actually watch the show. Then as they get to the far end, my shot's already pre-composed, and a lot of cameras also have a touchscreen on the back as well, so you can then literally just tap on the model and it will focus, take a picture. It basically means that you can actually shoot and also be a spectator as well. Okay, now here is the biggest tip that I can possibly give anyone, and this isn't just for fashion shows, it's for anything that moves, but specifically I see this a lot with Fashion Week. The models, especially if you're near at the front or near the front, the models are walking past, and they're walking, you know, left to right or right to left, whichever way they're going, and people will get their camera up, and they will wait, and then as the model comes past, click, and invariably these pictures always end up being blurry. And there's a reason for that, because cameras don't know what you're taking a picture of. They see objects to an extent, but if you put a camera like this, it's going to focus on the other side of the runway. It's going to focus on the front row on the other side. Because it's still and the thing's moving, then basically that's when you end up with this blur. So basically, if you want to get a model going side to side, we need to employ this photography technique called panning. The basic principle is that you follow and track your subject, i.e. the model, for the entirety of when you want to take a picture. So, for example, the model's going to start over there and walk past. I would literally follow her, click, and keep going. And the important thing is that you keep going after you've taken a picture, because if you stop, when you press the button, that's when it starts to take a picture, not when it finishes. So you want to keep going, and that will actually kind of reduce the amount of blur that you get on the model, and it will put all the blur in the background. Another really important tip is set your focusing, if you want to do this kind of shot, set your focusing to continuous or tracking autofocus. Depending on what your camera, manufacturer you use, it could be AI servo, it could be continuous AF, could be continuous AF tracking. You know, you'll have to check on your own camera, check the manual, or look online. But that will enable you to maintain a focus, because if someone's over there, they're further away. So when you start to focus, if you have it on single autofocus, it will end up being out of focus when they get to alongside you. So go for a continuous. It's still going to be a certain element of trial and error, because cameras aren't brilliant and they will sometimes go out of focus. It's going to be a hell of a lot more accurate than single autofocus. Manual would still be great, but you're not going to be able to get it fast enough unless you're using things like focus peaking and that kind of thing. And that will be something I'll do in another video. The other thing is that what we're ideally looking for when we're shooting a model on a runway, you want that nice wide leg walking shot. So unless you're epic at timing, and I remember on one of my old cameras, it had a delay between pressing the button and taking the picture, so I had to really time it perfectly. I worked out something like 0.3 second delay or something. So, but yeah, ideally we're looking for this wide leg shot. So to make it easier on yourself, so that you don't have to time it or whatever, put your camera on burst mode. So it'll either be burst or sequential shooting. You might have high speed or low speed. If you do have high speed or low speed, just play with it and see which works out best for you. And then as you get ready to take the picture, go click, 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 click. And that will hopefully get you a full stride worth of photos. And then you can choose the best one and get that nice wide leg shot. Another amazing tip, lots of people end up with that kind of yellow look on their pictures when they're doing Fashion Week. Cameras are kind of dumb when it comes to white balance sometimes, especially in artificially lit environments. So more often than not, I often find that if your camera's struggling when it's on auto white balance, just cycle through the different modes, try tungsten or daylight. It's normally one or the other. More often than not, it is daylight balanced, but have a look at the lights above. Often they will have different lights on before the show starts, but do it by eye. Ultimately, with all of these tips, is going to be try and do it to taste. Switch to white balance daylight, because that will help get rid of some of the horrible colors that you will often end up with. So guys, I hope these were really, really useful to you. If you like this, leave a comment and like, subscribe. planning to do a lot more of these little tip videos. I've got another one coming up that's going to be on how to shoot backstage at Fashion Week, which hopefully I'll have up in the next week or so. If there's anything else you want to know, or anything you think I didn't cover, leave a comment and I will make sure I reply. I don't do secrets, so hopefully I can help you make your Fashion Week a hell of a lot better.